A rip current is a wave generated current that occurs in the surf zone on any beach which you have breaking waves essentially, and it's characterized by a flow of water going offshore, so from the shoreline out to sea. As the waves come in and break over shallow sandbars, there's a force of water that comes onshore that builds up at the shoreline, so you get variable heights of the water level as you go along the beach, from areas where waves are breaking to areas where there's less breaking waves, and this drives currents that travel around the surf zone, and part of this circulation drives the offshore flowing element of a rip current. Some of the work that we've been doing actually measuring rip currents in the last sort of 5 to 10 years has really shown us that rip currents don't just flow offshore like they're sort of traditionally thought of as a river that flows out to sea. And in fact, the rip currents flow quite often in eddies or in sort of gyres cyclically within the surf zone. So that actually the current or the water body is actually contained within the surf zone and occasionally associated with pulses that ejects out beyond the surf zone offshore. So the flows are actually a lot more complex than we maybe previously thought. Rip current flow or rip current hazard is driven and controlled by a number of different environmental factors. One of them would be the wave height. So how much energy and how big the waves are that are approaching the beach will affect the strength and the type of currents you get in the surf. Another factor is the tidal level, so the water level and how that varies. Quite often the sandbars which generate rip currents are in this country, certainly in the west coast of Cornwall and Devon, for example, are all located around low tide. So when the tide level's low, you much get much more rip current activity compared to the equivalent high tide. So there's the wave height, there's the tide level, and the other thing is the beach type, on the type of sandbar configuration. So there's this very sort of integrated relationship between the current flow and how the beach looks and how the sandbars are developing. So the sandbars control how the waves break when they come to the beach, and that in turn controls the type of rip current circulation you're going to get. And these factors vary on a number of time scales. So sandbars can vary from season to season. The tides obviously vary daily, and then you have neap and spring tides every fortnight. And the waves can obviously vary from seconds to years. So you may have one particularly stormy summer with bigger waves than previous summer, and you may also get events coming in, so swell events that come from far away in the Atlantic, which come in and actually can surprise you. And within a certain day, you also have varying what's called sets or wave groups, which arrive at the beach with gaps of maybe 30 seconds to up to 10 to 15 minutes. So these variability and all these conditions can all come together and create what is a hazard on the beach, or a rip current behaviour which varies through time. The standard advice really, which is always the best recommendation, is to always try and swim at a lifeguarded beach. The lifeguards are there, they're experts at understanding spotting rip currents, and they know that beach very intimately, so they're able to guide you. They'll have the red and yellow flags which will indicate the safe area to swim, and really in that situation some of the requirement for you to understand the surf is taken away, for particularly for inexperienced bathers. If you're at a beach which is not lifeguarded, then always be really careful when you go into the sea, even when the conditions look relatively calm, because rip currents, if there's any waves breaking, are generally always flowing in some location. As a general rule of thumb, where there's waves and white water is generally the safer part, and where it's more calm and benign is generally more dangerous.